Salutations, celestial sightseers. David Fuller here with Eyes on the Sky. I have been working on my astrophotography, and I have been making some improvements. I got a long way to go compared to where a lot of other people are, but I've got some pretty decent photos going so far, and I was out the other night taking some images, and I will show you some of those, but it was mostly in the Ursa Major area because that's where there's some galaxies. And I was looking, if you look right here where Alcor Mizar are, you can follow this from Aliyah through Mizar. And then there's this little trail of stars that kind of go this way and lead you right to Messier 101, which is known as the Pinwheel Galaxy. So if you zoom in on that, you can see that's a pretty interesting galaxy. There's a lot of star forming stuff happening there. There's a lot of good spiral structure. It's not terribly bright necessarily visually, but if you're under some dark skies and have some larger aperture, it is something that you can find and see. It's well placed right now, so it's a great object to try and look for. But as I was taking my image, and I will click over to that, give me just a moment. So this was my image that I was using a dedicated astro camera with, and using the software SharpCap, doing a live stack. So basically it was taking 10 second exposures at a specific gain, which was relatively low. And every 10 seconds, it would add another image, add another image, add another image. I could play with the histogram a little bit. You can see that this image is not perfect. It's a little bluish. I didn't have any darks or flats. If you've watched some stuff about astrophotography with other people, you'll know kind of what those are. But basically those help to make the image better. Long story short, they reduce noise from the camera and dust on the image sensor and things like that. They also get rid of the vignetting that you can see here because I was not using a reducer when I took this. But overall, this is not too bad. I'm pretty happy with it because it was only 90 minutes worth of data. So that was pretty exciting that I was able to get that. And if you zoom in, you can see, oh, there's a decent amount of structure there. There's some nice curls to the spiral of the galaxy, and that was pretty cool. So I was looking at it and I kept seeing like this thing, and I'm going, well, what is that? Like, why is that showing up? I didn't know if it was something on my sensor. I didn't know if it was a light because I had a neighbor that had an upstairs light on. I didn't know if it was a reflection or something like that. It was just kind of like this little annoying thing that I kept looking at. And if we zoom way in there, you can see that's kind of what it is. It looks sort of like maybe a teardrop. There's a bright spot and some fuzziness around it. I was like, well, what is that? Well, when I went into Stellarium and started looking, I realized that, oh, that's a galaxy. What do you know? And that was pretty exciting because I was not capturing a lot of time on this. Now, granted, this particular galaxy is about 11th magnitude. The surface brightness is not all that bright, actually, close to 13, which is fairly starting to get into that pretty dim category, especially for something visually, at least. But I didn't expect to get a lot out of a 90-minute image. So when you crop that down and take a look at it, you can see that's pretty close. So if I zoom in here, like that's not bad. Let me center that. There's some a couple dots here. There's that bright star there. There's a dust lane. And sure enough, there's that bright star over here. There's a dust lane. There's these little dots. And I got all those on the corner of an image that I wasn't even trying to get, which I think it's really important that when we are doing astronomy, whether you're doing visual astronomy or astrophotography of any kind, whether it's electronically assisted or you're stacking things, that we embrace when something serendipitous happens. And to me, this was kind of a serendipity because I looked at this particular object and I went, well, what is that? And when I started researching it, I realized that, oh, hey, this is actually considered a companion galaxy of Messier 101. And Messier 101 is large enough that it's exerting a gravitational influence on this object, which is NGC 5474. And that was pretty cool to me, because when you look at what this object is doing, and actually let me show you a Hubble image. This is Hubble's image of it, which is obviously better than mine, but still all the same things are there. There's the star, there's that dust lane, here's some of those bright spots, all of which I caught. Obviously Hubble has much better detail, but it's still the same things. And what's happening with this particular half spiral dwarf peculiar galaxy is that it's being gravitationally ripped by Messier 101. And I found that amazing and fascinating and really, really awesome that I had this thing on my image way down in the corner that I wasn't trying to get. And it caused me to learn something about this object, which now I think is great, because I'm excited that I looked at what was there and realized that what I had captured was what should be there. In 90 minutes, in my driveway, with a telescope that's only 72 millimeters in aperture. Granted, I have some darker skies. Granted, I was using a dedicated astro camera, but I got that. And that, to me, is just amazing. So when you're using your telescope and you are looking around and you happen to find something that you don't know what it is, see if you can figure out what it is. If you're using binoculars, same thing. Binoculars are a great way to do this. Just scanning through, see what you can find. And if you locate something, go, what is that? And I would encourage you to investigate what those things are, because I think that's one of the best parts about this, is just stumbling upon something that you have not seen before, don't know what it is, and then learning about it and being amazed. And I was personally amazed by this particular object. I thought it was wonderful and I was excited. I will show you a little bit more of some of my astrophotography. So that's kind of my finished image of Messier 101. And there's an image I got of Messier 51, also in Ursa Major, which I can show you where that's at. We zoom out. Messier 51 is over here. So they're both kind of on opposite sides of Alcaid. And what's even cooler is that even though I was fascinated by that particular object over here, there's a couple other things over in this image that also showed up on my Messier 101. So this NGC 5477, that showed up. NGC 5473, that showed up. And there's the one, and there's the other right there. This was the interesting one just because it was larger and caught my eye more. But when you are out, go take a look. Enjoy the universe. It's amazing. It's awesome. There's lots of great stuff up there. And keep your eyes on the sky, your outdoor lights aimed down, so we can all see what's up. I'm David Fuller, wishing you clear and dark skies.